everyone, welcome back to Every Dance. This is episode number 4th of Know Your Indian Art. I hope you enjoy it. So let's go. Lini Roy was born on 11th April 1887 in a Palitur village of Bankura district, West Bengal, in a prosperous landowner's family. Later in 1903, he did his schooling from the Government Art School of Calcutta, where he was largely trained based upon the European tradition. At the time, Chamini became a good portraitist as well as worked great with the oil paints. But there was something more within Chamini Roy. He soon realized that he needed to draw inspiration not from the Western culture but from his own tradition. So he came back to the root. He chose to raise his voice as an artist by coming back to his homeland. In 1925, Roy became fascinated by this style known as Calicutty style. The unique features denoted here are the big almond-shaped eyes, the round face and the curvaceous bodies, which made it look more attractive. And moreover, he also with time soon shifted his focus to rural India and simplified his form. He used bold and sweeping brush strokes in his painting later on. Roy also abandoned the use of European paints in favor of natural minerals and vegetable-based pigments like from mud, rock, powdered seeds, flowers, and indigos. Yes, we can call it hashtag sustainability. In 1920, Chamini Roy started depicting in his paintings Hindu mythological god and goddesses like that from Mahabharatas and Ramayanas. Well, art has no gender, nationality, or religion. It is purely its own. So, Chamini did pure justice to this. He painted Islamic inspiring stories as well. He gave up on canvases and shifted to indigenous surfaces like cloth, woven blankets, mats, and wood.
In 1940, popularity of his painting reached an all-time high, but not only in India, but also in European households too. His art was everywhere, from Durga Puja, idols, saris, calendars, and school bags. However, Roy remained untouched by all the fame and recognition, with his concern being his art. Out of the over 20,000 work of art Roy painted during his lifetime, he rarely sold any of his painting priced higher rupees 350. If he felt that those who has bought his artwork would not be able to take care the way it was meant to be, he would immediately buy it back. He knew only his art, and perhaps that is what made that unique earthy quality that made it immortal. His artwork continues to be exhibited extensively in national and international grounds and can be found in public and private collections such as Albert and Victoria Museum of London has showcased in year 1954. Government awarded him Padma Bhushan. After spending most of his life in Calcutta, Roy passed away in year 1972. He left many of his paintings unsigned. However, his unique imprint on world of arts remains indelible.